The main incentive was, I mean, in TPM, so far there is not much research going on Africa. And if you see the worldwide context, if you see United Nations, if you see World Bank, and if you see the big donors, they are really doing a lot. So it's becoming a really hot topic. And it's also not fair that Africa remains behind and all other continents goes forward.
We had access to a lot of data that that normally we wouldn't have, and we thought we wanted to do something useful out of it, and this was a fun and interesting, challenging, short way of getting something out of the data. So yeah, that's the main reason.
When we started this event, we didn't really know what to expect, and I've been very pleased with the results. The groups all worked very hard. They worked late into the night last night, some till 4 in the morning, some till 2 in the morning. But we've never done an event like this before. I've never done a hackathon before. We didn't know what to expect, and we are extremely happy with all the work the groups put in and the results that came out.
Really, I'm just curious what all these students have come up with in terms of solutions for electrifying Africa. I found it a very interesting question, and I do hope to learn more about the possible solutions.
Well, over the past couple of, actually since I started my master, my interest in data kept on growing and growing, and hackathon was, I think, a good opportunity to just delve into that new interest of mine and see what it would, haul in.
I'm here today at the hackathon because the DEI, the Delft Energy Initiative, of which I am the chairman or chairwoman, we are sponsoring the event. And the Delft Energy Initiative sponsors various events created by students or by staff members, because the main purpose of the Delft Energy Initiative is to create opportunities for students and staff to interact and to learn. So we do a lot of things that make sure that people from different disciplines meet each other, talk to each other and learn from each other.
We are doing very well, so it's like 2 days of intensive work, but it's still 20 minutes left and we are up to get finished in time.
I feel like I'm a lot more knowledgeable on the subject now. And I think it's quite interesting, there's a bunch of questions to be asked, like is investing in like agriculture education versus electrification versus constructing roads, like which one of those should you prioritize? Because like the relations between development and electrification are very fuzzy.
Well, I suppose I work for a company, and so for me a wonderful outcome would be if some of the plans that will be presented are immediately actionable and not necessarily terribly ideological and not actionable. So if we can really start making some change in some places in Africa.
We use an optimization model. It's called in GAMS. It's one of the languages most used actually. And then we use some Excel script. And we found just a specific program that us Norwegian scientists use just to simulate the economical and demographic growth.
It's hard to say which approaches or which methods are most valid for this case, because it's such a broad problem and the different groups selected sub-questions within that. And based on those sub-questions, they chose methods. So I was happy to see a diversity of methods used, agent-based modeling, system dynamics modeling, regression models, GIS analyses. And I think all of those things are appropriate and necessary to use in combination to address the issue. So from that perspective, I think all of those methods are useful and relevant.
We find that on average there will be convergence in energy output. So that's, from an economic point of view, that's a good thing. What's a major determinant, important determinant in that, is log GDP per capita. Now you can say, well, how is this like identified? Well, we use instrumental variables to identify a causal effect of log GDP on the total net energy generation. Technology trends are important. A corruption index is important, especially life expectancy explains a large part of the total energy output per country. But now you can say, okay, so now you calculate a bunch of numbers for the entire continent of Africa. That's not really gonna help anybody. So basically what we do now is we make all these coefficients, we make them country specific. And then we can make some maps like this. So these are these convergence rates, but now plotted per country. The white ones were a merger problem, happens. Different identifying names of countries, small things. But the red ones are the countries that are showing fast convergence. But remember, that's conditional on the factors that they have.
So in the beginning, for smaller villages, for smaller communities, it is better to having a microgrid or having each person a solar panel, each person a small wind energy plant behind his house to actually get some electricity. And then when an overall national system is developed, when it's getting better, when it has around 50%, 60% electricity supply with hardly any outages, so 50, 60% means basically we have 50% of the energy needed covered with what we actually can supply, then it might make more sense to actually connect all these villages to a grid. Let's all try to make Africa smile and be concise and rational about the businesses we do, but let's not forget about what we want to reach and how we're going to reach it. And it doesn't make sense to bring technology everywhere to imply it on the people, but we should think about what we're doing, and we try to show with the model that there are different opportunities for every village, and there are different chances depending on what system we're going to choose, depending on population size, on affluence, on what people want to do there. Yeah, so thank you very much for your attention. And yeah, we got lost in Uganda, but we found our way out again. Thank you.
We believe by having more result-oriented, independently monitored development assistance that could help improve government performance. Furthermore, by investing in civil society, they may put pressure on the governments to also improve their performance. We also believe more investment in independent research institutes is highly necessary because data constraints are a major concern. But finally, we believe that it is a collective action problem. All of this that you mentioned is already known, but it is not being done. Why is it not being done? Because for every individual actor, it is more costly to invest if the others do not cooperate. Why would Shell have full transparency, accountability, demand that from its local counterparts if GDF Suez doesn't do it? If no one else in the industry does it, if the UN doesn't support it, if the local development agencies do not want it. And therefore, we believe that the key element is not so much we need more development assistance, we need more research institute, but more than anything, we need more orchestrated efforts by all stakeholders.
We try to focus based on the data that's available there, out there, by you guys, and try to come up with this energy intensity data. And one more interesting thing is, we try to convert the cattle data into energy intensity data. And because most of those people who are living in the rural areas possess some cattle, 4 or 5 or 3 or 4. So then we propose a solution which incorporates a solar PV and a biogas digester. And the biogas digester, we are inspired by the milk value chain where farmers give milk to a cooperative, as you can see here, and then to a town where it's processed. And they get the farmers get the value from selling the milk. You can do this for cow dung or for biomass waste. So based on this alternative, we go for off-grid areas. Of course, at some point, there will be a connection between expansion of grid and the off-grid areas. But this is quite a combination of available resources out there and the technology out there. And the way of doing it is based on existing infrastructure.
The winning team, the number one team. Now, we try in this event to be very unbiased. This event was organized out of the energy and industry section at this faculty. So, of course, our algorithm produced a result which made the winners actually members of our section. So, congratulations to team number 4.